Waiters ask, when setting castor and camber, does it matter which one you do first? So castor is probably the place that I would recommend that you start. What we need to understand is that every aspect of the suspension alignment can actually affect the other aspects. So it does become an iterative process. Castor is one of those aspects that we can almost consider independently. As I've mentioned as well already, we tend to find that castor is not something that we are going to be making changes to all of the time. We generally have a ballpark that we want our castor to be in. We're going to end up setting our castor during our initial suspension setup, and from there on it's seldom will we actually end up making adjustments. It's certainly not one of those aspects that we would be changing multiple times over a race weekend. So for that reason, the process really comes down to adjusting our camber and then adjusting our toe once our castor has been initially set. We do need to understand that camber and toe can interfere with each other, particularly at the front of the car. As we adjust our camber, this will affect the toe. So once we adjust our camber, we then need to go and adjust our toe. And multi-link suspension at the rear of some cars, we'll find that often the two will not actually have too much impact on each other, but it's very dependent on the individual car. That question was taken from one of our free live lessons. If you like free stuff and you want to expand your knowledge, click the link in the description to claim your free spot to our next live lesson. You'll learn about optimizing the performance and handling of your car on the racetrack, as well as improving your skills behind the wheel. Plus, you'll have the chance to ask your own questions, which we'll be answering live.